Hey guys, welcome back. And today we're going to be doing part two of my haunt build. Okay, so I have this old pipe that I found at construction site that they're just gonna throw away. I have a bunch more too. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna spray paint them kind of a metallic color and then get some orange, drip that down, make it look like rust. Just busted up pipes and I have a perfect spot for them in the haunted house. So I'll be right back with the time lapse. Now I'm thinking what I'm gonna do is hang them with maybe zip ties or something on the wall of one of the rooms, which will be the butcher shop. Now going on to the next thing, I have these old pots and pans that we weren't using anymore because they're all rusted, look old, and I thought they'd work perfectly in the butcher shop. And so one of them, I'm gonna have an actor hold, which is actually this one. This one's like metal and it's really loud, and I'm gonna have like a metal spoon or something and bang it on there in people's faces, and it'll be super creepy and it'll be loud, though. I'm hoping it'll be good. But here we go. I'm gonna spray some of this spray paint on there, give them like a burnt effect and just old. But here we go. So here are the pots and pans. They turned out awesome. It's kind of hard to see with the glare, but it looks better in real life than on camera. And you're probably wondering, there are some new ones. These. But there's also some missing that I decorated. And here's another thing that I made with them. Now you're probably wondering, why didn't you film it on camera? Well, I feel like y'all just wouldn't want to watch all that because it took a long time. Because I had to get the spider webs right. I had to know how I wanted them. But I think it turned out awesome. And this crate we found at a garage sale. Here it is. And then you have one pot, a bloody pot, some pot lids, another pot down there that you can't really see, and another lid. And this one, these are kind of like dirty and burnt. You can kind of see it on that. And there's all spider webs, make them look old. And then there's some more that I will show y'all. Okay, now here are the other things. Here's a pan that you saw when I was painting them. It has blood dripping down the side. And all I used, if you want to make this, is the permablood from Pale Knight Studios. And then some paint. And some expanding foam. And it was super easy. And then right here, we have a finger soup. Some red, kind of like blood. I just used resin. It's super simple. And it worked great. And I have some fingers in there. But there's some more kind of deeper. Like there's one right there. I don't know if you can see that. But it's kind of hard to see. Wish I put them more on the top. And then right here, I used some more resin. Kind of inspired by a witch's soup. Use some green. Some of these bones I had just lying around. And right here, a keg that I actually found at Goodwill. It looks cool. It kind of has some rust on the sides.
and I just thought it looked creepy. But I will probably be making more that you'll probably not see on camera. But these are the ones I have now. Okay, so as you can see, my hands are these little spider sacks that I've been working on. And I wasn't gonna put this on video, but then I decided y'all probably wanna make this, or y'all think that it'd be cool. But this is, I am taking some of this off from Wicked Makers on YouTube, and they're really cool. Go check out their channel, they're amazing. I love watching them. They make such cool things. They actually just uploaded a video, and they're awesome. So go check them out, subscribe to them. And all you need is the hot glue. This, the stuff all over is hot glue and an airbrush to give it that stringy look. And they do have these at Home Depot, little spiderweb shooters, or somewhere, wherever you can find it. And there's these little clear ornaments that break into two. And you can also use like water bottles, like the bottoms of water bottles, that works just as fine. And then a green and black wash. And as you can kind of tell, it's just a milk carton. But what I'm gonna be doing right now is putting saran wrap on them, and then use my heat gun to shrink wrap it, make kind of look like a weird growing fleshy type texture. So here we go. Product after the saran wrap, and you can use a hair dryer, like put it on high heat. It works good, but I definitely recommend a heat gun, is it'll be much easier on you. But here it is. They turned out really cool, and I'm probably gonna be putting a black wash on it. But I like how it is right now, though. Kind of makes it look like spider webs. But I'll be right back with a time lapse. Okay, so here they are. They turned out great. I love the, definitely do the gray and like kind of brown wash, because it definitely makes saran wrap pop out more. And it looks more like spider web. And you don't have to do the hot glue on it. You can't really even see it that much. Like, you can't even see it on camera that well. And in the haunt, you're not gonna see it that much, so. And I have to make another of these, so I'm probably not gonna do the hot glue. But these are really cool. And if you have anything kind of do spiders, maybe, that these I definitely make. You can get some spider web from Spirit or any store that kind of has Halloween stuff and put it on top. Maybe like drill a hole in here and hang it from the ceiling, and it looks great. So there's that video, and I will see y'all in the next video. Bye.